many Islanders you name the captain. What's your biggest challenge? What was your biggest challenge when you got to sea?
Well, I think obviously you're really proud. And for me, you know, the first Swiss-born playing, being, you know, captain in an NHL team, and then you have the Islanders, such a big history, you know, and a great franchise. So it's a big challenge, you know. You gotta find the right mix, because you need to play well, and you gotta focus on your own game. But then, you know, it's all about the team, and that was a big challenge, you know. And I loved it. I think it was a big honor, and I learned a lot. But it's not easy, because you want to perform. You know, you have to play well in order to help the team. But, you know, it's all about the team. So team first, you know, like on the ice and off the ice. But for me, my motto is like, you lead by example. What do you do every day, before practice, during practice, after practice, the way you train, the way you live, and that was my thing.
Who's your favorite player on the team? Who are you closest to?
Oh man, that's so many great guys on the team, and a lot of great memories. I mean, Frans Nielsen was one of, you know, great friend, and we live both in Garden City and got really close. So we're still in touch, and then obviously a guy like Johnny, Kyle, Dougie Wade, like so many guys, and Billy Guerin, just a lot of classy guys.
I remember you put some fear in the Penguins in that playoffs. What do you remember about it?
We were right there. You know, I think end of the day, you know, like tiny things make the difference. And I know we lost game 6 in OT. It was devastating, but we were really close. And what I remember was how unbelievable the atmosphere in the Coliseum was like. It was so loud, like the people were there in the morning, like tailgating, and it was just such a hype, you know, after not making the playoff for so many years, and then we made it in that shortened lockout season, and everybody was in, and I think we gave the Penguins a hard time and a hell of a series, and we were right there. Unfortunately, we came up short, but I think it was one step, you know, in the right direction, and you know, the team is still moving forward.
Now, pick a goal that you'll never forget. Your goal as an Islander.
Oh, there's so many. probably not the prettiest goals, but in that series, I had one game when I scored 2 goals, and they weren't pretty goals, but just, you know, in the heat of the moment, playoffs, and just the atmosphere in the Coliseum. I thought the roof was going to blow off, and just so much emotion, and worked so hard for it for 4 years, and then you finally get there. They weren't pretty goals, but they're goals, and that memory I'll never forget.
You got close to Johnny Tavares during the work stoppage. You together in Switzerland. Tell me about that. You got to know him pretty well.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, as bad as the lockout was for all the players, the league, and the fans, I went back to Switzerland, to Bern, right away, and I decided to play for my hometown team. And then I was really happy that, you know, Johnny came as well. And he lived in my apartment for a few weeks, then he got his own place. And I was so excited for everybody, for myself, obviously, for him, for the opportunity, and then for the team, for the fans, for everybody, for the young players in Bern, and because they learned a lot. They saw a great player working so hard every day and being so competitive in practice, obviously all the games. As bad as it was not playing in the NHL, I think we made the most of it.